What's up, guys? Anklespankin here, and today we are playing as DIEana in the top lane. And I am going to be running somewhat of a odd build, if you will, at the beginning here. I am going to be double jungling with our Udyr, so that is why I'm grabbing the Doran shield. It'll be better for this lane anyways, too, because I'm going to be going against a Gameplank or a Garen, one of the two. And I really just want to... I want to live lane. That's what I'm trying to say. I couldn't think of the words. I just wanted to live in the lane phase. Because I don't really think that I'll be killing these guys too much in the top lane. Especially not with the Fiddlesticks in the jungle. So we'll see how this goes, though. And this DIEana top lane was a total panic pick. So that's kind of what we're playing. But tomorrow, preseason begins. And also, tonight, I am going to be downgrading to Windows 7. Well, upgrading, basically, from Windows 10. From a content creator's point of view, it's definitely an upgrade. But we should be good to finally be streaming a lot more League again. And streaming on preseason is going to be a lot of fun. Because preseason, in general, is going to be a shit ton of fun. So I'm really looking forward to that. Anyways, apparently double jungle sucks starting tomorrow. I'll have to actually read through the current patch notes. I have no idea why he said that, but I'll take his word for it. So we'll see. We will see. The preseason is going to be awesome, and we'll see what it holds for us. Let's go ahead and just work on this blue. I am supposed to be the one tanking because, you know, I'm, you know, the double jungly. And I got my shield just to make it that much more painless. And we'll go ahead and just wait for him to kill it. We'll get the experience. Walk up to the wolves. You know, the standard procedure. And we'll see. It looks like I will be against the Garen. Not a big surprise there at all. So, no surprise really in the slightest. So, let's go ahead and... Okay, well, I missed the top little one, but I almost stole the big one. Kind of glad I didn't, because that would have made me a rude dude. But let's go ahead and go back here. It looks like Garen was probably double jungling with his homie as well. Whoa, wrong blue thing. So, what I wanted there was the mana potion, not the scrying orb. But it looks like we actually do have a minion advantage building towards us, so I will be able to see us a lot more safely. This lane is definitely going to be kind of shitty, though, I gotta say. So, we'll see how it goes, though. We'll do our absolute best. We both have 5 health potions, but Garen has Garen passive. So you know he's already going to be doing quite a lot more sustain than we will. And I'll have to be very careful about using my abilities so sparingly. Because I only got the 1 mana potion, and that just ain't going to be enough. So, wow, that damage. I mean, maybe that was more minions than Garen, but still, good lord. Let's go ahead and get one of these potions ticking just to be safe. Go ahead and grab that, and maybe... he's running teleport, right? Okay, yeah, he is running the teleport, so no worries there. Go ahead and get that auto. And whap! Bop him a little bit there as he bops me back. But, you know, whatever. I like being bopped. So, wait, why'd I auto that one? Ugh, I ruined it! Okay, soiled it! Oh, God, okay. It's okay. It's okay. So, 14 to 16. Yeah, I'm actually going to take a 1 minion lead right here, but... as you can see, I'm getting my asshole railed right now at the moment. So, we may have to retreat a little bit tactically, of course, because, retreating is just... you never retreat. You just tactically reposition. So, you know, it's never, ever retreat. That's... No, never. So, with our W, though, we can get these minions all low enough to get one hit off on them. Then we get the minion. Except when the minion, or like, our minions ruin it. But whatever. So, this guy probably still has a bunch of potions. He does currently have 3. My shield has gone off. So, I need to be a little mindful of myself. Looks like first blood will go down onto the Gameplank mid, though. So, good job, team. And I am out of mana. I'm going to go ahead and let this last HP potion tick me up. And keep on the CSing, because like I said, I was not expecting much of anything, and I didn't know how much damage my auto was going to do there, so I was a little hesitant to use my abilities, but that is A-OK. Let's go ahead and just leave this where it is. No reason to try and push our luck or anything like that. So I'll just keep on chilling and chilling. And whoop. No, not gonna get it. Fuck. I was really hoping for that shield to come in big. So come on, Garen, do it. Actually, don't do it. I don't want to lose any more health. Dude, this Garen is just handling me. And it's so... Oh, it's hot. But I'm thinking as far as builds go, to go against Garen here, we're going to have to run not really a weird build, but I'm probably just going to have to go straight for a Seekers. Which, no surprise at all, but that's probably going to be what I have to do here. So Garen is probably backing. No, he's not. I mean, he doesn't really have a reason to back, but I do after this wave. Actually, I have a reason to back pretty much like right now, because he's going to hit 6 off of this wave, and then he can probably dive me. Because I don't have mana, I'll have to actually flash. But as long as I'm in EXP range, maybe I can get, get it like that. He probably, I doubt he's going to go for the dive. Because right now I'm actually relatively healthy, and now I have my ultimate as well. So it is very possible that he goes for the dive here. But, okay, let's go ahead and just flash. He will flash too, and never mind, he's gonna die! So, very interesting. I really, really didn't think he was gonna go for that. But, whatever. So, I'll take it. I will definitely, definitely take it. So, returning the kill in this lane, all because he just did that dive like super, super greedy and very, very over aggressive. And actually, this is kind of very bad for me that he's pushing this, because Garen's teleport is going to be up. Or he's not using it. Okay, if he's not going to use it, then this is good for me. Well, kind of. Because it okay, the wave should end up coming back towards me, and that's where I want it right now. Because for a while, I'm not going to be able to do shit. I had to get the Seeker's Arm Guard just for a little bit of AP and a little bit of armor to go against Garen. Where he's probably, he's going straight for a Black Cleaver. No surprise there. And I'm going to be going for Zonya's and Nashor's Tooth. And basically, all of my plays are going to come from teleporting. So let's see. I would teleport onto that, but they don't need that. Like, they don't need me at all. Unless, okay, unless they're not going to get it somehow. I saw Thresh super low, I saw an Ash in that lane, and I was like, they don't need me. So let's go ahead and get both those minions real fast, and we'll keep on chilling. I know for a fact that I cannot fight Garen. I'm sorry that this has to be a boring lane, but if I don't want to sit here and be a super feeder dog, I have to play it like a bitch. So, 100% sorry. Not much of anything I can do about it, so big sigh, but we'll all have to suck it up and deal with it. So, gonna queue right in the middle of that, get those minions, tank these right outside my tower range, just to make sure that my minions kind of cut them off a little bit, and we'll go ahead and just jump this guy and do some good damage here on him. And that will be, I mean, at least it's something, right? At least it's something. So just keep an eye on the minimap at all times, as usual, just to make sure there's, you know, not a potential play that we're missing for our teleport. So now, this time, I can say with a lot of confidence that he's very likely not going to try and dive me. Because from full health, that's a bit of a stretch, even for a broken-ass champion like Garen. So I'm starting to think that maybe on that back for the Seekers, that I could have also gotten a crystalline flask and been in a pretty good situation for that. And actually, that dive that he got on me, come to think of it, it wasn't the worst thing for him. Granted, he did miss a lot of minions off of it, but oh god, okay, well this is bad. Nothing I can do about that one. So, not a single thing can be done about that. Gonna just get fiddlesticks ulted and absolutely annihilated there. So, nothing I can do. I am going to teleport to top. So, Fiddlesticks with a very good ultimate, I gotta admit. But as I was saying, Garen actually got a lot more out of that dive early because I died before he died. I mean, he got the experience for killing me where I didn't get the experience for killing him. So, he was actually able to get a level lead. And I'm choosing not to teleport to this tower right now because I want to leave it up. I know it seems kind of weird to keep saving my teleport and saving my teleport, but it's going to pay off. What the fuck? As long as we get a good teleport, it's going to pay off. Because I didn't even miss that many minions at all. I missed, like, two. So, not going to sit here and cry too much about it. Let's go ahead and get the auto attacks. Boop. And we'll just keep on chilling and farming. So, it looks like they do have a deep ward in that lane. So, if they actually push, I can teleport behind them. And it should be a pretty easy double kill for, well, generally for us. Hopefully, our Udyr can get something done up top for us soon, because I am at least getting to the point where I can kind of help a little bit when it comes to a fight. But if he doesn't come up here, I do not blame him at all. There's not like a super big reason that he would, but let's go ahead and just fight this guy a little bit. If he wants to duke it out like that right in our face and our minions, definitely can't say no to a fight. So go ahead and miss that, pop the shield. And it looks like he does want to continue scrapping it out. And I will miss that Q, sadly. It looks like Irelia is running for her life. But as long as we continue to scrap it out with this Garen and not just let him have damage on us for free, we should not be in a bad position. The only, I guess, issue, in a sense, would be the fact that it's Garen. So, you know, he gets his all this sustainability from his passive, and I need to be very careful of that. So, just going to end that trade there. I am going to go ahead and... No, I'm not going to drop my pink yet. Because if I drop my pink right now, he could actually just go clear it for nothing. So I'm not gonna go drop that yet. And let's see. With the trades he's picking, if only I have more mana sustain. Because then I would actually be able to potentially kill him soon. But as long as I keep farming up, keep gaining the experience, I'm A-okay with where I am in this lane right now. I am absolutely very content with where I am in this lane. I'm very far down on CS compared to him. I'm down a kill, but I'm still happy with where I am in this lane. I shouldn't be, because it's Garen, and he's a broken-ass champion, and he's going to outscale me, like, super hardcore. But I am. I'm totally fine with it. I am not worried in the slightest. So Garen is going to stay here. I'm going to go back, and I'm going to grab a shit ton of mana and health potions. And this time, I'm going to use the teleport. Because I feel like it's going to be too many minions this time for me to just justify missing. Because it'll be more than one wave if I don't teleport back to this one. But that fucking... Oh, God. That mana use. Man. I'm starting to think that if I go top lane DIEana, generally... Well, I think this build is fine for this game, but if I can't go Flask, I think that's going to end up dicking me a shit ton. Like, that is gimping me here, dude, for sure, like 100%. Or, hopefully, I can pick this into an AP matchup, so I can go for an Athene's. But we are going to get some good damage off on this tower. That is definitely, definitely good for us. Looks like a teleport is coming in mid, probably just get our game plan going back to lane. It was... Go ahead and see if we can clear this, and whoop, go ahead and just do all that damage. Launch that Q, totally miss, and actually, I'm not sure I can win this, so let's go ahead. I'm actually going to flash, and I'm dead. So, you guys, Black Cleaver. Looks like Jinx Rocket also came up top here, and Gangplank Ultimate. So, a little unnecessary on their side, but... I didn't realize just how low on mana I was getting so fast. So that is definitely a recurring issue that we are facing in this lane. So I'm going to just need to keep farming. Wait until I get my Gnasher's Tooth and go from there. Sadly, teleporting was not enough. I overstayed my welcome, wasn't paying enough attention, and I managed to die for it. So that is a bit of a shame. And we're going to have to play from a deficit this lane or this game, but I don't think it's going to be too difficult. Because Jinx is going to be my main target anyways. Jinx, Gangplank, Fiddlesticks, anyone that I can really do a lot of damage to really fast. So basically, not Garen. Thresh, depending on what build he goes for, could be a good target for us. But for right now, just going to keep on chilling, keep letting my team hopefully do their thing. And I'm going to keep doing my best to just relax here. So let's go ahead and just try and fight with him a little bit. We'll go ahead and just get some good damage there. Look at that. So, even though it was clearly a losing fight, or a losing trade for us, we are still not just going to let him beat on us for nothing. So, if he goes for the auto attack, let's go ahead and just pull him in here. So that'll be some good tower damage going off for us, and some good damage going off on him. Go ahead and use the ultimate just to make sure we get that minion. Make sure we have all of our potions taken here as well. Sadly, again, this mana issues, man. If I had mana, I would be able to all-in him and try and kill him right there. But I just simply don't have the mana for it. That's so obnoxious. Holy shit. And, like, I never realized how annoying that was to not have a mana item on DIEana. But that's okay. Even with how much we're getting analed by this game plank, we are still doing very well in this lane overall. Like, all things considered, being only this little CS down with, you know, how we're being treated in this lane is not a bad thing. And I need to be really careful with taking this tower, because I don't know where Garen went. I'm assuming he went back, because he's not killing me yet. So we'll go ahead and take that tower. That'll be definitely a very necessary pickup for us right now. There he is. And, oh, okay. Again, I'm not really sure that was necessary. Fiddle, flash, and GP ults. But I'm just not... I don't understand the necessity behind all that. I was getting greedy for the farm there, so I could hopefully get my Gnasher's Tooth. But apparently, I don't think that was actually worth it for them. Like, in all honesty, that was a lot of resources used to kill me, and I am not worth a lot of money right now. So I truly don't think that was worth it. I'm gonna go ahead and teleport mid, actually, just to make sure this game plank doesn't try anything too spoopy. I don't feel like I'm gonna be able to make any plays right now, because there's not any wards down way low on the map, so I can't go for anything bot lane. And just to negate any potential push on that mid lane, I just kind of teleported there. We'll go ahead and drop our pink. There is nothing in there. Gameplank, or not Gameplank, Garen is definitely still just gonna go for health, probably go for a dead man's plate next. We'll go ahead and just do some damage there to him, just to show him that I ain't scared of no Garen. But we are getting very close to our Gnasher's Tooth, and then the damage can begin, because even though we are 1-4-0, I'm going to show you guys that DIEana is still a force to be reckoned with, 100%. And let's go ahead and keep an eye on this Garen. So let's go ahead and interrupt that. So let's just get him out of that little teleport there. No teleport for you, sir. And that will be definitely... He's not going to be able to kill me, or he's going to go for it. No, he's not. So definitely not going to go for that. But getting him out of that little teleport is going to be very good for my team. Now, I'm actually going to go back here. I might lose the tower for this, but I think it might be necessary. So it looks like Ash gonna go in, and Irelia gonna go down, and uh-oh. I don't know what that flash was for, but it looked cool, and the heal is coming out. No, it's not gonna pay off. And that will be all of them going down. So I think I'm just gonna go for Ionian Boots here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for Ionian Boots. Now, I probably shouldn't have just sat in base while I was thinking, but it is okay. So at least we got Garen's teleport on cooldown by interrupting it like that. We lost our tower. Apparently we lost a fight that I thought they would totally be fine to win. Because logically, right, if they pick decent fights right now, the rest of my team is very far ahead of the rest of their team, because I'm the one that's not ahead of the Garen right now. So logically, right, if they're ahead, you know, if Garen is the one dunking me here, and then my team is dunking the rest of them, then they should win a fight, right? But I guess they just chose a bad fight somewhere. It happens to the best of us. And it looks like the kill scores are at least even. Our Ash is getting pretty huge. Irelia is getting farmed. And I am getting there. Basically, the looking at the builds, it really just looks exactly like the Irelia and I just were actually the mid and top laners. But, well, we are the mid and top laners, but, like, I was the mid laner and she was the top laner, and, you know, we just kind of switched roles. So Garen definitely just going to be able to He has me by the balls right now, man. I can't fight him because I fell so far behind. If I didn't get so dicked by a couple ganks like that and then just messing up lane early, I think I'd definitely be in a lot better position right now. But, you know, always live and learn and always try and improve. So it looks like they are going to be picking up two kills right there. And I'm guessing Garen is going to try and rotate down to assist his team. So I'm actually going to take this chance to come out of my little peephole of a lane and try and push. Now, the reason I'm choosing pushing over trying to help right now is because I want to get this Gnasher's Tooth. And I'm so close to heaven. I believe I'm only 70 gold off at this point. And if I can just keep getting pressure up here, that is going to be more use than I'll probably be in a team fight right now. So, definitely look at it that way. We have the gold for our Gnasher's Tooth now, and he is going straight for a dead man's, or he already got his dead man's plate. So very standard Garen build on him. And now we are definitely going to be a lot stronger. It looks like he is. Oh, okay. I thought he was like on the prowl for me or something. I was like, oh God, is he gonna find me? But he didn't. Oh boy, it looks like they are going in. And maybe, I really considered teleporting there, but then Garen was coming and Phil Six was already walking back towards the way I was going to be teleporting to on this ward. So he's pretty much no doubt going for that dragon, but I think with our Irelia down, there's not much we can say about it. So I guess we're not going to attempt too much. But with the Gnasher's Tooth, 40% CDR, we have the on-hit magic damage now. I have a lot of things going well for me. And next up, I will be going for that Zhonya's so I can actually fight, like I can dive into the back line. And then Zhonya's if, you know, things get risky or frisky, and we'll see where we go from there. But, like I said, or like I keep saying, just keep farming right now. Because that is what's going to be our salvation. And I need to move because Garen is coming up behind me. Hopefully Udyr can come up behind him. Okay, never mind. He's just going straight for me. Or he's going straight for the wave. He doesn't even care about me anymore. It's like he doesn't even love me. Wait, is this guy for real? Alright, I'm down. I'm fucking down. It looks like he really wants to do this. Holy shit, we're doing this really fast. Okay, I feel you. That's gonna be a beautiful 22-minute Baron. Great call. Fantastic call on his part. That is good. I did not expect that to go as well as it did, but it did. So let's go ahead and recall. Get out of here. The teleport is still up, so we can look to keep pressuring top and teleport anywhere a fight breaks out. Now, with the Baron buff, pressuring top is going to be a lot easier because with Baron buff minions, my pressure of the top lane is going to be a lot more of a threat. And Garen's teleport should be up, assuming he hasn't used it, you know, since we interrupted him. So we'll see how that goes. But I do need to be careful with my mana. Because even though I have Baron, I don't have any mana regen. But I am getting very close to having my Needlessly Large Rod. That is good. That is very good. Hopefully as this game goes on, I might be able to get the blues. But we'll see. I'm not going to beg for too much. I definitely won't be sitting here like, oh, give me the blue. But it is a possibility. Actually, I'm going to recall get my Needless now, because it's not going to be worth me stalling out getting a Needless right now to teleport in. So I'm just going to get a Needless and come mid with them. Because if we can dive, that's pretty good. With our team, it's actually looking like we probably could dive if it really comes down to it. So the hook not going to land. God, they are squishy. I like the look of that. Because that means that's our ticket to getting right back into this game. And as you can see, even though we're 1-4-0, we still have the most CS on our team at 189 at 24 minutes. Now with 1-4-0, 189 at this time, 195 now even, is actually very good. So we got to give ourselves credit where it's due, and we need to watch out for the Fiddlesticks ultimate that can only be thought of as inevitable, but looks like this tower is just gonna go down. Maybe we can go on this. I don't know if I want to. I don't know if I quite want to. So let's see. It looks like kaboom. That's gonna be, wait, come on. Yeah, there's one kill. Let's go ahead and pull her back in. No, I'm not gonna get another kill on the Jinx. That exhaust definitely will be killing me, but picking up a kill on Thresh in exchange for my Baron buff, probably not worth it. But I really thought I'd be able to get both of them. But sadly, the exhaust kind of shit on me. So a great exhaust from Thresh. But still will be getting one kill and my Zonias. And that was... I'll still take it, because we got the tower. We still have Baron on two of our people. And I can actually teleport behind these guys with this ward probably right here would be my best bet. But I'm not sure about doing it. I'm not sure. I think I'm just going to run top for now. Because there is a large wave building. 2-5-0 now with getting decent farm. But... let's see, what other items should I go for? Definitely a Lich Bane is a good choice. That'll give me a little mana, as well as obviously the big on hit for doing more burst damage. So that's definitely a very good choice. Rabadon's great choice. I probably won't need any penetration for a while, because none of them million MR. And why would they, right? Like, I'm the only magic damage source, and I'm not strong. So that actually works out, again, in our favor. Because if I don't have to spend the money on buying a Void Staff, I can buy more impactful AP items, you know, like Luden's Echo, or like, why am I the villain? What the fuck? Alright, well, I know Fiddlesticks was up here. I saw him on that ward, so I'm not going to go too far. In fact, I'm going to get out right now. So let's see. He is 16. He is level 16. How is he 16? Alright, so let's see here. How am I gonna get myself out of this one? Let's go ahead and drop that shield, keep on shielding, and I should be fine to get out here. So, maybe... never mind, it's Garen. I forgot that Garen is a mechanically intense champion, and can do 1,000 true damage. Why am I the villain? What the fuck? Why was... like, did I actually get the most recent kill? That's pretty funny. Oh, Fiddlesticks going to be going down! And Garen is going to come in from the side, but maybe not going to have too much of an effect. Ooh, game playing bullets right in the face. And, well, if he's going to run right into him, he isn't going to have much of an effect. Whoa, that hook barely missing. The flash for the flash. Good flashes. Let's go ahead and grab this thing, because I think we will go for that Lich Bane. Because like I keep saying, though, I guess I need to pick my fights even more carefully. I should know better than to think I can even get close to a Garen and be safe. Especially one who's huge. But just in general, I need to be much more careful. So, let's go ahead and go for that. Maybe I could have gone in on that. Maybe. It's possible. It's very possible. See, one thing that you have to do is DIEana. Now, I know it sounds weird, and I know that, honestly, a lot of you guys are probably like, what the fuck is this idiot talking about? He has no idea what he's doing. Wait, did you just steal that? Or did he just kind of do it and then, like, walk away? Either way, great job. Great objective control. But, anyways, one thing that I know a lot of DIEanas do wrong, like, horribly wrong, is they will not go in. When they, like, even if they're, like, if they're having a bad game, you can't not go in. Now, I know how weird it sounds. Usually I'm just like, no, you gotta be a bitch. You can't just overstep what you're capable of, right? But it's like, you really, really, really sometimes just have to pull the trigger in a team fight. Especially once you have your Zonias, that's when you have to just go. Because if you can get the damage off, if you can burst enough damage off on people in the first place, get your Zonias, maybe get more cooldowns, you can still be terrifying. Especially in a situation exactly like this, because I am deceptively strong right now. And I'm going to keep reinforcing that point, because it's so important for you guys to understand that I am not out of this game in the slightest. I'm definitely not like a terrifying force right now. But I'm not something they can just count out at all, because I will do a shit ton of damage if they are not careful. So, basically, what I need to do is not suck a dick. Okay. Looks like that's coming in. Uh-oh, Jinx could be in a bad situation here. And, yeah, gonna get the kill. Whoa! This could be good or very bad. This is more looking like it's more on the bad side. And let's see, maybe... oh, God. Get out of here with that. Oh, jeez. Okay. And... oh, God, he's godlike. What did he do? I tried to get my Zonias off, but I couldn't do it in time. I was dead. But, so that, I don't even know what just went so horribly wrong, in all honesty. But it looks like Grudir is going straight for the tower, and they are going to teleport in. They might be, I don't know, actually, they totally can if they just have Gameplank and Fiddlesticks on it. That's a very easy Baron for them. So I'm not sure what Grudir is doing. Not sure at all what Grudir is doing. Okay. Oh boy. And the juke back into it. Actually, wait. If Janna can ward. Get on it. It's so low. Oh, fuck yeah. Hell yeah. Let's go ahead and grab this. And Udyr actually managed to stall them long enough that we're going to be able to get this Baron, because apparently Gameplank and fucking what's-his-face couldn't do it fast enough. Oh god, that was horrifying. Alright, god, you bitch, man. Okay, whatever, got the Baron, gonna get our first assist of the game, and let's go ahead and grab this top farm and go grab our Lichbane. So apparently I am the villain again somehow. I don't know, but there's our level 16. That's gonna help a shit ton too. So, definitely maintaining our relevancy. This is good, and I'm gonna see, where's the next wave? Next wave is right here. And you can always tell where the next wave is just by looking at any of the other waves in the game. So just a little tip thingabob there for those of you that are like wondering, where's the next wave? How does he know where the next wave is gonna be? It's because you can look at other waves. Like, you can look at other lanes, and they all go at the same time. So, Lichbane complete, 374 AP. Definitely need to go for a Rabadon's next. That'll give us so much AP. And then, obviously, the only person I won't be able to go for is the Garen. Going for all that MR, I'm not going to do shit to him. Since I have zero Magic Pen, well, aside from, you know, my Runes and Masteries. Whoa! That's not looking too good. Gameplank Ultimate coming in. And, Hilla, that's gonna be one kill. Kaboom, come here, buddy. That's gonna be a double kill for me right there. Looks like, the Garen's coming in. Gonna be definitely not strong enough to just fight us like this. Let's go ahead and drop this shield. I do need to keep in mind that I am the villain, and if I get ulted right here, I will die. So, no, yes, there's the ace. Getting me back, 6, 7, and 1 now, 3 kills going down for DIEana, and Udyr getting that top lane turret, so playing it beautifully well. Great job, Spankin. Thanks, Spankin. And since my team does not need me to push right now, well, push with them, because I'm not going to get there in time in the first place, I am actually going to go to this big wave, this billion up bottom, push with my Baron buff and get some more pressure in here, because off of that ace, that was a massive ace for our team. It looks like we will get one inhibitor, maybe, yeah, we're definitely not going to get the second one right there, but we will get one inhibitor in mid, that is good. And, as I just displayed, I did the DIEana thing, where even though I'm fucking immensely not fed, I still did a trillion billion damage, so that is good. That is very, very good. My teleport will be back up in 2 minutes, looking like they are going to be going for, whoa, the Jinx going to be making her great escape out of there. Looking like the Q is not going to be strong enough to kill it, and let's see, I definitely should back right the fuck off now, because if Garen comes to me, I'm not going to be able to fight him. I probably won't even be able to get away. Nice miss. But, we'll go ahead and steal their red while I'm over here. The dragon is up. I'll go ahead and take that while I'm over here as well. And that is very good. Udyr actually managed to get the top lane inhibitor as he got out. So, great job there, buddy. We'll be able to, I don't know about this one. I'm backing off. This is not safe in the slightest. Not even close. So, let's go back here. Trying to think what I can do at the moment. I'm definitely going to grab home guards, and I think I'll sell this for a blasting wand. So that'll give me more AP. Grab me the home guards. All good stuff. And really, we have no reason to do anything other than really just all group bottom and push right now. Due to the fact that with two inhibitors down mid and top, those lanes will pressure themselves naturally. They'll push super hard on their own. So now we just gotta make a manly pilgrimage down to the local bot lane. And we'll just see if we can all, group up. And why? Why is everyone pinging 14 billion times? Stop, please. I don't like that. It makes me nervous. Please go mid. Why? There is no reason for me to go mid. There is absolutely no reason for me to go mid. So basically, what I'm gonna do is boom! That's gonna be, whoa, boom! There's the kill! Easy pickings, and let's go ahead and see. Wait, I'm the fucking, oh god, oh jeez. Oh no, I don't, whoa! Oranges boy going down. I need to be extraordinarily careful about running in there. And Garen is gonna get exhausted, is gonna get stunned. And let's see, there's the Sterix gauge, and boom! Whoa! Going to get the Zonyas right there! And come on! Oh god! Ah! Going to, god. So, well, apparently they just want to fight us as Udyr wins the game. I'm okay with it. So Udyr are gonna get one Nexus turret. That's gonna be worth me dying. I tried to live as long as I could. Will succeed in that endeavor. So definitely worth my time. And they have three inhibitors down. There's really no way they win this game in the foreseeable future. So when I'm up, I do have my teleport. I can teleport onto some random ass minion that's tanking the tower shots. You know, see if I can make lay epic fedora tipping plays XD lol winky face. Ha 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 ha. Ha 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 ha! But we'll see what goes down. So, as you guys may have seen there too, if you didn't see the damage I did to Fiddlesticks like instantly when I saw him channeling his ultimate, then I actually suggest you go rewatch that. Because I did a lot of damage to him very quickly. So looks like Udyr has been spotted, but we'll probably just be running out of that. So I'm actually kind of confused about his build, but whatever works for him. So Baron is up in 30 seconds. We should definitely just grab that. If they leave, we should Baron. Because basically, if they leave to stop our Baron, I can teleport into their base because, you know, three inhibitors down. They're not going to be able to leave their base very well. But, let's go ahead and get this guy right here. That is definitely going to be a boom. There's the kill. Easy 100-0. Going to be killing him there. And this Baron is going to be going right into our hands. Now, it looks like their inhibitor is respawning. Ash has found a Fiddlesticks. Will not be needing us. Never mind, she totally will because she QSS nothing. But Janna going to be over there for the assist. We'll be able to get this Baron foe free. Well, let's go ahead and see what we can do. So my teleport is up, not going to bother teleporting to anything silly, just to like look flashy, just going to keep playing it safe. We are 8-8-2 now, we are huge in this game, and this game is pretty much over. Wait, no, they surrendered? You slut! God damn it! Oh my god, I just, aww. Alright, so I want to see still how much I did, because I probably didn't do like a shit ton of damage, but we definitely were up there, I'm sure. Well, not up there, but definitely like, yeah, we were up there. We ended up being very high up there, right up with the rest of our team. So great job on that aspect. And definitely came back huge in that game. Went from what, 2-6 to 8-8? Either way, like, that was a very, very good example of why you can't just like give up, or why you need to know how to keep yourself relevant and what to do at a given time. So my team definitely did do a very good job in helping aid that process, but we definitely had to put a lot of it on ourselves as well. So still pat ourselves on the back there. Job well done. And if you guys did enjoy this video, this will actually be the very last video of season 5. So goodbye season 5. You will not be missed. Honestly, you fucking sucked. season 6, please. I'm very looking forward to preseason. But if you guys did enjoy this video, do make sure you leave a like and a favorite. It really does help me out. If you want to, you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Twitch. All three links will be in the description below. And as always, I love you guys. You have a wonderful day. Peace!